Welcome, Ranjini Sharma for Trinity Mirror News. Parents urges government to open school building. Middle school building constructed at Minnur near Ambur at Velur. It has so far not opened, and where more than 150 students were studying in that school before construction started. An amount of Rs 1.60 crore was spent for the new building, which was still not opened by government. This leads the anti-social elements where consumes liquor and throw bottles in and around the school buildings. To stop this menace, the local people urged the government to reopen the school building at the earliest.
ஆறு மாத காலமாகியும் பணிகள் நிறைவடைந்தும் இன்னும் பள்ளி வந்து செயல்பாட்டிற்கு வரவில்லை.
Tripura Chit Fund scam depositor thronged the Chit Fund office and demanded immediate refund. The defrauding of hundreds of depositors of Tripura Chit Fund company to the tune of several lakh rupees. The Chit Fund allegedly lured depositors by offering huge interest. The Chit Fund authorities defrauded the depositors by not paying their deposit amount even after maturity time. Depositor thronged the Chit Fund office and demanded immediate refund of their deposits and went on dharna in front of the Chit Fund office.
பே பண்ணியிருந்தோம் டோட்டலி இப்போ வந்துட்டு 14 lakh பே பண்ணியிருக்கோம். அந்த நியூஸில் வந்துட்டு சீப் பண்ணி போயிட்டாங்க, காஞ்சி வாட்ச் எல்லாம் ஏமாற்றி போயிட்டாங்கன்னு சொல்லி கேள்விப்பட்டு கேட்டிருந்தோம். கேட்டு சரி நாங்கள் கேன்சல் பண்ணிக்கலாம் பிரச்சனை இல்லை அப்படின்னாங்க. சரி கேன்சல் பண்ண சொல்லணும்னா இங்கே ஆஃபீஸ் வந்துட்டு ஒரு 1 வீக்காக வந்து கன்வின்ஸ் பண்ணிட்டு இருந்தாங்க. மேனேஜர்லாம் கூட வந்து ஆஃபீஸ் வந்துட்டு இல்லை சார் பண்ணலாம் அது வெளியே எங்கேயும் பிரச்சனை.
Hyderabad tops the income tax defaulters list among cities across the country. Hyderabad has the highest number of income tax defaulters among cities across the country. The Telangana capital has 25 defaulters, followed by Ahmedabad, which had 20. Across the country, there are 96 defaulters who owe a total of Rs 3,614.14 crore as income tax for assessment year starting from 1980. These are individuals and companies from whom not a single rupee can be recovered. In most cases, the department has not been able to trace the assessee. In some cases, the assessees are bankrupt. In most of the 96 cases, the department has lost hope of recovering even a single rupee. There are 69 assessees who have been named as not traceable, while 24 are bankrupt. We'll resume back after a short break.
I'm ready. போலாமா?
இப்படியே வா. கோவிலுக்கா? கோவிலுக்கு எப்பவுமே ட்ரெடிஷ்னலா வேஷ்டி கட்டிட்டு தான் வரணும். ரூம்ல ராம்ராஜ் பாக்கெட் வேஷ்டி வச்சிருக்கேன். ஆம்பளையா லட்சணமா கட்டிட்டு வாங்க.
வெண்மையில் தரிசனம் வேண்டுதல் நம் வசம்.
இங்க இது கோவில்.
ஓ சாரி.
செல்போன வேஷ்டி பாக்கெட்ல வைங்க. வேண்டுதல மனசுல வைங்க.
ராம்ராஜ் நெக்ஸ்ட் வெல்க்ரோ பாக்கெட் தோத்திஸ் டெம்பிள் கலெக்ஷன்ஸ்.
Welcome back. 18 people killed and 19 others injured due to fog in China. A highway pileup caused by low visibility due to fog involving at least 30 vehicles killed 18 people and injured 19 others in eastern China. The injured were being treated in hospital where the condition of 9 is said to be serious. Fog enveloped a section of expressway in Fuyang City in East China's Anhui province. Over 30 vehicles collided due to low visibility on the expressway, leaving 18 people dead and 19 injured. Several vehicles caught fire due to the accident, which caused about 3 to 4 kilometer long traffic congestion on the highway. According to the report, about 20 firefighting trucks were rushed to the spot and the fire was extinguished. The accident spot was left with twisted and burnout wreckage. Pakistan rejects China's offer to build dam in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Pakistan has turned down China's offer of assistance of $14 billion diameter Bashar Dam. Moreover, Islamabad is learned to have asked China to take the project out of $60 billion China-Pakistan Economic Corridor and allow it to build the dam on its own. The project is located in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir, which is claimed by India. The Asian Development Bank had earlier refused to finance the project because it was to come up in a disputed territory. Pakistan Pakistan would prefer to self-finance the project instead of accepting extremely tough conditions set by Chinese companies. Sources in Pakistan said international lenders were stipulating serious conditions with the provision of funding, and the project cost had reached $14 billion against the original estimates of $5 billion. That's it for the news bulletins. Thank you. Have a nice day.